Other, for all of us, we We are gathered here in this beautiful circle of creation. Support and bless Jan.
Jen?
Dan. And we are all invited in this process to be and to become together. They've invited us to form their special, their beloved community and to help create this moment in their life together. We are here to bear witness to their covenant, which is made in the sight and the grace of God. Please pray with me now. Creator Christ and Comforter, be with us, bless this day, bless this couple, bless this gathering. Be with us every step of the way, wherever our paths may take us, and remind us to call upon you. And now, we ask that you will be with us as we pray together. And I'm going to ask that Patty come forward and lead us in the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And now, if you would all rise, we are going to sing together Amazing Grace, the words of which you should be able to find on the right-hand side of the program.
A while ago.
not if I were to die, I won't explain. I fain would ask my friend, how he won a time or a life, that love is more lovely than anything to me. I'm so proud. But for the truth or known, love cannot speak, but only thinks it does. Though surely to a leap, without the help of grief, burning hot. A man may love the truth if he practice it, beauty he may admire, and goodness not a bit. But as much may befit to reverence. But only when these three together meet, as they were combined, and make one soul the scene, in favor of truth and loveliness. When under kindred shape, like loves and beauty, into each other and on each other and become supportive and trusting of each other. Dan says that they are complementary. They play into each other's strengths and weaknesses because they're good at different things. Dan says that they balance each other and it never gets old on a grand holistic scale. Jen puts it like this: when Dan is fiery, she is icy. They have complementary personality traits. He's type A and speaks his mind. And sometimes things get away from him and he might get a little frustrated and angry. But Jen has a much higher threshold for that. She might be able to pull him back a little bit. And other times where she would be reticent to speak up for herself, Dan encourages her to say what she needs and to balance the way that she gives to others with self-care so that there's balance for both of them and she's able to be present to others, to Dan, but also to herself. They are best friends. They are strong partners, balanced and cohesive, and together they can achieve things that either one of them alone wouldn't dare to do. They love each other as is, and yet they challenge each other and encourage each other to reach and grow as individuals. They express how much growth they have experienced together since they first met. And they can't imagine a dream with anyone else or alone. They are adventurous and they are creative. If they shout adventure on a Saturday morning, they'll go on a car trip and see where it takes them. They love music. But the way that they wanted to describe the anecdotes that they used to describe the special relationship they have actually came down to cooking. For instance, Dan measures things when he's cooking. And surprisingly, Jen doesn't. He's more methodical in nature. And Jen doesn't fool Dan even if her clients think she's very organized. She's a little bit all over the place with the cooking. So she says. They tell stories about how their two moms both assess their relationship through cooking. In their early dating days, Dan's mom Diane came over with Puma. And you guys decided to make apple crisp. And they went out to get the apples. And since they cook together quite a lot, they know what each one is going to do. But Dan's mom asked, how are you keeping track of who's doing what? And how did you manage to not put the same ingredient in twice? And because neither of them was speaking, and yet they each had a role, and they worked together in tandem. And their apple crisp came out apparently just right. They consider cooking a metaphor for their relationship. Cooking is a microcosm of how their relationship comes out in the meal. Because they're great partners and they can accomplish a lot together. They divide and conquer. They give each other jobs. They acknowledge each other's strengths and adjust accordingly. Usually someone is the boss in the kitchen, but that's not who they are. They share it. Jen's mom also threw them a cooking challenge. She wanted them to make pepper biscuits together. Apparently this is a special recipe. And achieving it together is a test to the way that they work and their competency as cooks. They had to make the pepper biscuits with gluten-free dough. And it came out just right and they worked together just fine. So, we've gotten the mom's seal of approval for both sides of the family. And they say that both of their moms are opinionated and admirable, strong and supportive. And their moms are exacting judges of human nature. So to receive that approval, both as cooks and as partners, is a big deal. Jen and Dan say they're still developing their cooking brand. Their cuisine this new family circle that they've been creating. You are all part of the recipe that they've been concocting. That's why you're here with them today. You're part of the ingredients that make their life special. And their loving bond is blended from the strengths and gifts that come from their families of origin. But today they are creating a new family. And this family is different and it is special. It is strong and balanced. It's loving and it's good for you. And it's zesty. Some parts are thoughtfully prepared and precisely measured, yet there are dollops of surprise and spontaneity. And we can be sure that together, in this love that they are creating and this bond they are forming, that they will make more than they need so that they can give it away and share it with others. This is the holiness of the promise that they are making today. And now, we will exchange apples. Gather and bear. you to receive now their blessing. And this is your part. We're going to see how enthusiastic we can get you to be. If you will willingly support you, the members of their beloved community, and uphold Daniel and Jennifer, please say together, "We will," with enthusiasm.
We will.
We will. This time.